कांग्रेस प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस दैट्स ऑन इन द कैपिटल, लेट्स लिसन इन।
उन्होंने स्वयं अपना राजनीतिक क्षेत्र सीमित किया हुआ है, रायबरेली और अमेठी जो उनके भाई और मां का संसदीय क्षेत्र है, ये उनका स्वयं का निर्णय है और मुझे लगता है कि हमें हर व्यक्ति के व्यक्तिगत निर्णय का सम्मान करना चाहिए। Can I let her ask the question since I told her, and then I'll come to you.
Sir, I have the same question.
Yes.
I have the same question.
Okay. Yes.
दोनों जगह राहुल गांधी ने कैंपेन किया।
After ma'am. Ma'am, I cannot speak about individual perception that you may have. I only believe that she has, Shrimati Priyanka Gandhi Vadera has decided on her own that she has restricted her political role to the two parliamentary seats of her brother and mother, and we should respect her decision. मैं ऐसा नहीं मानता। भारतीय राष्ट्रीय कांग्रेस के करोड़ों कार्यकर्ताओं का विश्वास श्री राहुल गांधी जी में है, उनका सम्मान, उनकी आशा की दृष्टि, उनकी आकांक्षा सम्मिलित तौर से और एक स्वर से श्री राहुल गांधी जी में है। व्यक्ति व्यक्तियों को कई बार इस पर शक हो सकता है, पत्रकार साथी इस पर प्रश्न उठा सकते हैं, प्रजातंत्र में हम उसका सम्मान करते हैं। जहां तक कांग्रेस जन है उनको ना इस पर कोई शक है, ना कभी शक था और ना कभी शक रहेगा।
मिस्टर सुरजेवाला, व्हाट परसेंटेज ऑफ कलेक्टिव रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी वुड यू एट्रिब्यूट टू कांग्रेस प्रेसिडेंट एंड स्पेशली पर्टिकुलरली राहुल गांधी फॉर दिस डिजास्टरस राउंड?
Well, I wish people could dissect victories and defeats in percentages. But fortunately or unfortunately, that is never done. It is a fact that we have lost the states of Maharashtra and Haryana. But let me also respectfully remind you that we have ruled Maharashtra for 15 years in a row. Something that was unprecedented and unheard of. We were the original, we commenced this contiguity of governments before many other states and BJP governments also took over and they followed suit. However, to segregate defeat or to assign responsibility is neither possible nor practical. The truth is that we fought a good election in both the states. Haryana has never been voted to power twice. We formed a government twice consecutively. We formed a government in Maharashtra thrice consecutively. And people have spoken and we have said that we respect their verdict. We will continue to work hard. We will introspect. We will do course correction where required. We will build new leadership where necessary. We will go and reach out to newer sections wherever is found paramount or necessary.
Madam, after.
If I understand correctly, ma'am, you are speaking, you are asking me a question, a proposed reshuffle of the organizational hierarchy. As far as a reshuffle or a possible change of general secretaries of All India Congress Committee or the body of the All India Congress Committee goes, the Congress Working Committee has authorized the President of Indian National Congress to do so at an appropriate time. I am sure we shall be able to inform you as and when that decision comes. Sir, if you, well, firstly, I believe that parliament and state elections are not necessarily copybook replicas of each other, and you would grant me that. Secondly, if you look at Haryana, a state that I come from, BJP led on 58 segments. They've gone down to 47. We led on much less. There's no consolation that we've got 15, but we led actually on much less. Almost identical, you will find, would be the results for Maharashtra. But the truth is that in democracy, ultimately, who gets the majority is what matters. And despite fractured mandates in Maharashtra and a clear mandate in Haryana, people have spoken, and we respect that. And I, as I said, we got our act together. We set out a clear-cut agenda. We laid out a roadmap both in Haryana and Maharashtra of what we wanted to do. People have not accepted it. And in democracy, you must respect when people do not accept it. And we respect that. Yes, sir.
At the last moment, the issue of third-class men was played out in a big way by BJP. Do you think that the issue proved to be the last player? And secondly, would you challenge BJP government now to drop the issue and come out with this?
Sir, with due regards, we have clarified the issue umpteen number of times from this podium itself. Unfortunately, Prime Minister has become habitual of raising issues which neither have substance nor are founded on correct facts, only to gain brownie points during elections. If I may respectfully remind you, as also your viewers and readers, same issues were raised prior to Parliament elections. 150 days have gone. What has happened? Cronies of Bharatiya Janata Party have filed at least three sets of litigation in three different courts, including the apex court, that is the Supreme Court of India. Those litigations were rejected, dismissed as vexatious and motivated by these courts, including the Supreme Court. No wrongdoing, I again repeat myself, no wrongdoing and no favor was ever done to any individual, including to Shri Robert Vadra, in any land dealing of any nature. And similar allegations were leveled in Rajasthan. Nothing came out of it. Prime Minister, despite the high office he holds, chose to level based on newspaper stories which were not founded upon facts, similar unsubstantiated allegations. Nothing is bound to come out of the same. And they have a government in Rajasthan now. They have a government in Haryana. They also have a government in at the nation, in Delhi. They are welcome to examine each and every transaction. I can say with great confidence from this podium, there is neither any wrongdoing, nor any favor, nor any twisting of rules. Everything is in accordance with established rules and regulations. आप अगर 2009 में हरियाणा की सरकार के गठन की बात करें तो मैं आपको सादर याद दिलाना चाहूंगा कि हरियाणा जनहित कांग्रेस के लोग जो उस समय कांग्रेस से अलग होकर गए थे, उन्होंने उस पार्टी को रीमर्ज कर लिया था और 5 वर्ष के बाद उस पर यह ठीक है कि चुनाव के बीच में एक निर्णय आया है सिंगल बेंच हाईकोर्ट ऑफ पंजाब एंड हरियाणा का, पर वो फाइनल निर्णय नहीं है। हमारा ये मानना है कि जो 5 लोगों ने 2009 में हरियाणा में मर्जर किया था वो उचित था, ये एक पक्ष है। परंतु महाराष्ट्र जैसा बड़ा प्रदेश जहां पर किसी दल को स्पष्ट जनादेश नहीं मिला है, वहां लोगों की तोड़फोड़ करके खरीद फरोख्त करके, जैसी दिल्ली में भी कोशिश की गई भारतीय जनता पार्टी के नेताओं के द्वारा, या आया राम गया राम को प्रोत्साहित करके सरकार बनाने का निर्णय ना नैतिक ना संविधानिक किसी भी मापदंड पर खरा नहीं उतरता। हम ये आदरणीय नरेंद्र मोदी जी, अमित शाह जी और भाजपा के विवेक पर छोड़ते हैं कि चाल चेहरा और चरित्र की बात करने वाली वो पार्टी जिन्होंने इसी चुनाव के दौरान एक राजनीतिक दल को हफ्ता वसूली पार्टी कहा और दूसरी राजनीतिक दल को नेचुरली करप्ट पार्टी कहा, अब वो उनमें से क्या हफ्ता वसूली करने वालों के साथ जाएंगे या नेचुरली करप्ट पार्टी के साथ जाएंगे, जो उनके शब्द हैं। It's a very valid question. States like Haryana, which are among the progressive states of the country, need to be governed with caution and care, with proper diligence qua allocation of funds for development. I also want to remind you that in 2004-05, when there was a BJP-INLD alliance government in Haryana, the development budget of the state was 1800 crores. We have given the state back to them with development budget of 27,000 crores. So it's a over 10 times jump. Actually, it's about 150% jump that we have given them. That happened on account of expansion in the size of economy, prudent financial policies of the state, and expansion in the resources of the state, taking the state at number one position on many fronts. We will be very happy if Bharatiya Janata Party adheres to its promise of raising the old age pension from 1,000 rupees to 2,000 rupees, and I personally will be the happiest if unemployed of the youth of the state are given 15,000 rupees a month as unemployment allowance, as BJP has promised. We hope that the new government comes up to that promise, and I am sure they have adequate resource allocation from Shri Narendra Modi ji and Shri Arun Jaitli ji to back up this plan. Can we have Aditi?